Hi and hello guys, today in this video let me show you all as to how you can set up Constacanx Android 11 TV version on your Raspberry Pi 4 port along with the Google applications or the gaps. So without any further delay, let us get started. So in order to get started, first head over to Constacanx page for the ATV build for the Raspberry Pi 4 board. In the last update that he has pushed out, that is on the October 11th, he has refreshed the user interface for the Android TV build, and this looks really great now. Click on the link and first download the Android TV build image. So by default, the Android TV build will take up just about 7 gigabytes of your storage. So in order to expand and make full use of your storage space, scroll down and you should find a file called resize.zip file. Click on this resize hyperlink and then download the resize zip file as well. So once you are done downloading these two files, next we need the gaps file or the open gaps file that will install the Google applications on the Android TV build. Head over to opengaps.org. So in that, the platform that you need to select should be ARM, the Android should be version 11, and then the variant will be TV stock. And once you click on the download button, the gaps package will download. So just in case, as a backup, in the description of this video I will attach a link for the last stable version of the gaps that I used. Okay, so now you are done downloading all these three files, you need to burn the Android TV image onto an SD card. So in order to write the image onto the SD card, I'll be making use of the Raspberry Pi Imager software. You can get a copy of this software from the official Raspberry Pi website. Okay. First, click on Choose OS. When you are here, keep scrolling down until you see an option that says Use Custom. Click on that and then select the Lineage 18.1 2021 1011 unofficial ATV build. And then choose Open. Click on Storage and then select your desired SD card or desired storage and then choose Write. And then choose Yes. If you get a pop-up something like this which says insert disk etc etc, just press cancel. Okay, so now the image has been written. Click continue and then close the Raspberry Pi Imager software. Next, copy the resize.zip file and the gaps file that you just downloaded onto a thumb drive. Okay, so once you have the resize.zip file and the gaps file copied onto the thumb drive, you can plug out the thumb drive as well as the SD card, connect it to the Pi and then boot your Raspberry Pi. Okay, so once your Pi boots, the Lineage OS should start booting. And see, if you get a prompt which says searching for accessories, press on the F2 key on your keyboard, which is the back key. Okay, so if you are an avid follower of Constacanx work, you can see that the user interface has been refined. The setting up process of the Lineage OS is very easy, just follow the on-screen instructions. Set your desired language, choose next. Set your desired date and time and then choose next. Connect to your desired Wi-Fi network. See, if you are okay with the operating system using your location and services, leave this box checked. Otherwise, you can uncheck this and then choose next. And go through the Lineage OS privacy policy. And if you are okay with the terms and conditions, select this box over here. Otherwise, you can uncheck this box and then choose next. You can skip the pin part. You don't need a pin for your Android TV. Choose skip and then choose start. Okay, so now the TV build should start, but as it is, you won't have the Google applications. Now let's proceed with the installation of the Google applications. Click on the gear icon at the right top. This looks more slick than what it was previously. Okay, keep scrolling down until you get to the option that says system, and under system head over to the option that says buttons and then select advanced reboot. Now go back. While under system, keep scrolling down until you get to the reboot option. Select reboot and then select recovery. Okay, so now TWRP has loaded. Hold your mouse on the set of arrow keys and then swipe to allow modifications. Click on the install option. At this point, you should have the thumb drive containing the copy of the resize.zip file and the gaps file inserted into your Pi. And then select storage, select the USB that you have inserted, and then choose OK. See, if you don't see the zip files, probably you have a wrong option selected over here. If you select on install zip, then your zip files should be visible. First, we'll install the gaps. Click on the gaps zip file. Leave these two options unchecked and then choose to swipe to confirm flash. Okay, so once the gaps has been written, click on wipe Dalvik and then swipe to wipe. Okay, so now as it is, do not reboot into the system. Click on the back button and then back arrow key down at the bottom that you see. And now install the resize.zip file. Once again, leave these two options unchecked and then swipe to confirm flash. Okay, once again, choose to wipe Dalvik, swipe to wipe, and then keep going back. And now click on reboot and then choose system. Okay, so once the Lineage OS boots, you should get this screen with the remote, which by itself indicates a successful installation of the gaps. See, if you have any other issues like the Pi constantly restarting, or if you don't get the screen, I would suggest you to recheck the gaps that you have installed or you have attempted to install. When you see this remote, press the back button or the F2 key. And now you should be welcomed with the usual Android TV setup screen. Select your desired language. And now you need to set up your Android TV. I would suggest you to give skip so that you can log in with your Google account. Connect to your Wi-Fi and now choose sign in. Now you can set up your Android TV using your Google account. Okay, now go through the terms and conditions and then choose accept. If you want, you can share your location information, otherwise you can give no. Once again, if you want to provide useful information to improve Android, you can choose yes, otherwise no. And that's pretty much it. Now we should be welcomed with the Android TV home screen. So as you can see, we have made full use of the available storage on the SD card. The Pi plays 720p videos easily without any hitch. But the Pi that I am having right now is without any cooling on it. As a result, it is getting a bit warm, I should say. And if I try to switch to 1080p, I do get some frames that are being dropped. Pi tends to drop frames while playing the 1080p videos. At this point, my Pi is getting really hot, so I could attribute these dropped frames because of the Pi heating excessively. See, if you have a good cooling system on the Pi, probably you can test out playing the 1080p videos. But for sure, I can say that the Pi plays the 720p videos without any hitch. Okay, so if you are wondering if the Disney Plus app works on this build, I can confirm that it does indeed work. Okay, so if you are wondering if the Disney Plus app works with this build, I can confirm that it does indeed work flawlessly. Okay, so that is pretty much it, guys. So that is how you can install ConstructAnk's latest version of the Android TV build on your Raspberry Pi 4 board along with the Google applications or gaps. Okay, so I really hope that you find this video useful and informative. Thanks for watching. Take care and bye-bye.